These ancient Chinese records show that Jesus Christ is God 2,500 years before Christ was even manifested in the flesh. Now, guys, I gotta tell you, this finding is crazy. I'm gonna go ahead and show the video. Please don't forget to smash that like button. Comment below what you guys think about this and share.
Hallelujah.
This is crazy, guys. Let me go ahead and start it off so that we can skip the intro. But this is going to be really interesting, guys, because if you guys don't know, in Asia, it's seen as untraditional for being a Christian because they believe that Buddhism is their true faith. That's far from the truth, guys.
That we have embraced a foreign Western religion, a religion of the white people.
And so we
kind of feel a little embarrassed. Especially during Chinese New Year season. You meet your family and relatives and say, oh, we hear that now you're a Christian. You no longer love your family. You no longer love your parents anymore, huh?
你再不爱你爸爸妈妈了.
Or they will say, well, you know, now you jiakangdang, is it? Because if you're Chinese, you should either be a Taoist, a Confucianist, or a Buddhist.
因为如果你是华人, 你要就是道教徒, 要不然佛教徒, 要不然儒教徒。
Now I want to say this, that those are great religions.
我要告诉你, 那些都是很好的宗教。
There are many, many millions of believers and followers of Buddhism, Taoism, and Confucianism.
在今天世界上, 有上百万追随着道教儒教。
There's a bunch of Confucianism behind those religions, though.
But today I want to give you a little bit of education. Turn to your neighbor and say you're going to enjoy the word. The Chinese history has a 4,500 year unbroken record.
整个中华的历史将近有4,500年不断延续下来.
Let's take this to be 0 BC.
把这个当作公元初年.
So now we are here, we're at 2009.
现在我们在2009年这里.
Year of the ox.
牛年.
If this is a youth service, I'll say, turn to your neighbor and moo. All right, anyway.
不可以跟旁边的moo, huh?
Moo, okay. But you know what? The Chinese history stretches until 2500 BC. Now, Taoism came about 6 BC.
道教大概是公元前60世纪来的.
About the 5th BC, you have Confucianism. And you have, I spelled wrongly, Buddhism.
而大概在公元第五世纪的时候，有儒家跟佛教出现。
So the big question is, what about those 2,000 years?
问题就在这中间2000多年呢?
Before Taoism, Confucianism, and Buddhism, what did the Chinese people believe in?
在道教、儒家、佛教出现之前，华人相信的是什么？
What is interesting is this. We have very clear historical records.
很有意思的,我们有非常清楚的历史记录在。
For the first 2,000 years of their history, the Chinese people worship a singular supreme God and not many dozens or millions of deities.
在这2000多年当中,华人一直在敬拜的是一位独一的最高主权的真神,而不是许许多多的神明。
They worship a God by the name of 上帝,
他们敬拜的这位叫上帝的神。
Today I'm going to write in my broken Chinese.
今天我要来练习我的中文字。
All right. Now, and this, when you read the historical records,
当你读到整个历史记录里头,
上帝 has exactly the same character, nature, and power as the God of the Old Testament.
实际上这位上帝跟我们旧约相信的神有同样的品格、同样的性情、同样的能力。
But while the Hebrew people called him Yahweh or Jehovah,
虽然犹太人把他称为耶和华或亚伯,
the Chinese people from the beginning called him 上帝, the King that lives above the Most High God.
华人却把这位神称之为上帝，是一位君王，在万物之上，居在天上的。
Some of them call him as 天 or as 上天。
也有人把他直接称之为天了。
Now you notice how you write the word 天？
你注意天怎么写？
Everything that is big, that is star, he's bigger than them. He's the most high.
在天下至大至上最高的那个就是至高神。
So the Old Testament calls him the most high God.
所以旧约里面称他为至高神。
Let's give the most high God a big clap. Hallelujah.
为他热烈的拍一掌。Hallelujah.
China's greatest historian was a man by the name of Sima Qian.
在中国当中有一个非常了不起的史学家叫司马迁。
In his classic historical records, he recorded of a king called 皇帝 or the Yellow Emperor.
而在他流传千古的著作《史记》当中，记载了第一个人叫皇帝。
Now, 皇帝 is supposed to be the originator of all Han people, Han Chinese.
皇帝基本上是所有汉族人的始祖。
He lived around 2400 BC to 2500 BC. That means right from the beginning.
他所居住的时代大概是公元前2400到2500年，在最开头的时候。
And Sima Qian recorded that 皇帝 actually built an altar in Taishan, which is the mountain in Shantung province, to worship 上帝 God, the one supreme God.
司马迁记载，皇帝特别到了中国山东的泰山，在那里为上帝这位神筑了一座坛，崇拜他。
Sima Qian also recorded in his historical records a comment by a Han Dynasty scholar.
而司马迁在史记当中同时也记载汉代另外一位史学家的记录。
Well, the Chinese, I'm going to ask Lu to read what was written.
这位史学家郑玄他写的中文是说，上帝者天之别名也，神无二主。
In other words, 上帝 is another name for 天。
上帝就是天的另外一个名字。
And he says,and he says this, the spirits do not have two lords. In other words, the Lord your God is one.
他讲得很清楚，只有独一真神，没有两个主。
Again, it confirms exactly what the Old Testament says.
再一次又印证我们旧约所教导的。
Now, there is also a song found in the collected statues of the Ming Dynasty.
另外在大明会典当中有一首收集到的当时的歌谣。
I am not even going to attempt to try to read the 文言文。
哇，读这个文言文大概会昏倒的。
But Lulu is able to do it, so let's.
Lulu 可以为大家念出来。这边这个歌谣他说：鱼袭洪荒之初兮，浑蒙五行未雨兮，两曜未明，其中挺立兮有。
Wow, guys, this is crazy. Literally, as you guys can see, this is the book of Genesis found in these ancient Chinese records. But then to further prove the point, they worship the monotheistic God. It's not this polytheistic Buddha, big fat Buddha man that you rub his belly. That's not who they worshiped, guys. Thousands of years before Buddha, who did they serve? And these are the important questions we have to ask.They literally worship the Abrahamic God that we worship today. That's what the newfound evidence supports, is that the Chinese people actually worship the monotheistic Abrahamic God of old. This is who they worshiped. And so literally we see the Triune God, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit manifested in the Torah and the Old Testament. So if they followed the Abrahamic God, they also follow Jesus Christ. They worship the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.And this was all 2,500 years before Jesus Christ was even incarnated into the flesh. This is really interesting, guys.
无容身，神皇出于西，始判浊清，立天立地人兮，群物生生。
Now let me translate it for you.
这个要为大家解释一下了。
Of the old in the beginning, there was a great chaos without form and dark.
在创造之初，一切是混沌灰暗的。
The five planets have not begun to revolve, nor the two lights to shine.
五颗行星尚未运转，那两个光体也未照亮。
In the midst of it, there existed neither form nor sound.
在这当中，既无声响，也无形体。
You, O spiritual sovereign, came forth in your sovereignty, and first did separate the impure from the pure.
而主权之神啊，唯有你出来判断所有清浊之分。
Now notice the order. You make heaven, you make earth, you make man. All things became alive with reproducing power.
注意它的顺序哦。你立了天，立了地，创造人，使这一切万物生生不息。
Turn your Bible with me to Genesis chapter 1 and verse 1.
跟我一起翻开创世纪第一章第一节。
Doesn't this commentary sound exactly like the book of Genesis?
这里是不是就像为创世纪写了注释一样?
It says in verse 1, in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth.
第一节说起初神创造天地。
The earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep.
地是空虚混沌，渊面黑暗。
And the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters.
神的灵运行在水面上。
And then it says God separated light from darkness, and the land from the waters.
最后神将光与暗分开，水与地分开。
And he created.
And guys, this is where it actually gets really interesting, because right after they talk about the verses that you actually find that they quote in the ancient Chinese manuscripts and records, they actually discuss how the whole Chinese language was actually created and formed around the word of God. And that is our concrete evidence that they followed the Abrahamic faith. And this is where it gets very, very interesting. So please continue watching until the end.
Created trees and plants.
他创造了树木、采书,
fish and birds and beasts of the field, and then he created man.
有鱼、有鸟、田间的野兽, 之后他创造人。
And Genesis 1 says, all were given reproducing power to produce after their own kind.
而创世纪告诉我们, 每一个都有生育的能力, 照他们各从其类的生产。
Can you see, long before all this worship came in,
你看到早在这些拜偶像的事情之前,
long before Taoism, Confucianism, and Buddhism,
早在这些道教、儒教、佛教之前,
before there were temples that were full of idols for you to worship,
在那些有很多庙宇、那些偶像拜敬之前,
for 2,000 over years, the Chinese people worship a singular supreme sovereign God who is the creator of heaven and earth, and his name is 上帝。
中国人在2000多年一直在敬拜是一位独一有至高主权的神, 他的名叫上帝。
Who has the same nature, character, and power of Jehovah Yahweh God of the Old Testament.
而他的本性、品格与能力跟我们旧约的亚威上帝是一样的。
Now, nobody knows when Chinese writing was originated.
没有人知道中文的文字起源在哪里。
But most will agree, Chinese writing came about probably in 2500 BC.
可是大部分人都同意，大概公元前2500年就有了中国的文字了。So
centuries before the Egyptians built the pyramids, you have the Chinese writing.
所以在埃及人还没盖金字塔，好几个世纪之前，中国人就开始写字了。And
with Chinese writing, with the ability to write, that means you can document history.
在中国人能够有文字写下来，代表你可以记载历史了。Now
this is very interesting.
这就很有意思啦。Because
from the time they were able to document history, there were several global events that everybody could remember.
在他们能够有能力记载历史的时候，有一些全球性的事件是大家通通记得的。During
the same time as 2500 BC,
就大概在公元前2500年那样的时代里，you
have the flood.
在这之前有洪水。You
have the Tower of Babel.
在那时候有巴别塔。Now,
what are the events were there, the people possibly, if they were alive, and if those events were true, they could remember.
而在那个时代还活着的人，还有什么样的事情是人家永远不会忘记的呢？
Now, I mean, wouldn't you agree, if there's a flood that covers the whole earth, then you definitely you will remember.
如果一个全世界的大洪水，你大概一定都会记得吧。
If there is a Tower of Babel that caused people to be scattered everywhere and languages to come forth, surely you remember.
如果巴别塔使得人们四散到各处，语言变乱了，你一定会记得啊。Now,
if those events were true,
如果这些事件是真实的,
and that the Bible is not a fable,
圣经不是随便的神话故事,
then the people that are alive around 2500 BC, they must remember the creation story.
那在公元2500年的人，他们也不会忘记创造的故事。Because
Adam was alive 1,600 years before.
因为在1,600年前，亚当还活在世上呢。You
see, when the flood came, you know, Methuselah just died.
你要了解，是在马土撒拉刚死的时候，洪水降临。And
when Methuselah was alive, Adam was also alive.
当马土撒拉在世的时候，亚当也还活在世上哦。In
those days, the people lived a long time.
那个年代的人活得很长寿的。Adam
lived 900 years.
亚当活了900多年。Methuselah
969 years.
马土撒拉活了969年。In
fact, it was only 8 generations from creation to the flood.
实际上从创造到洪水才8个世代而已。So
if these things were true,
如果这些都是真实的,
then people alive must surely remember them.
当时存活的人也一定记得他才对啊。
And surely they want to document down in their historical records.
也想在他们的历史当中记载下这一切。
Now, Chinese writings are unique because somehow they have this ability to capture Chinese history.
华文的文字之所以特别，是它可以有这个能力记载历史的。
Because they don't use letters, they use characters in picture form.
因为华文不是用字母拼组在一起，而是用形态显示出来的。
So every Chinese word not only expresses a meaning, it captures a history.
因此，每一个华文字不但是表达意思，还能够带出历史来。
Every character tells a story.
每一个文字可以讲一篇故事。
So if all these things were had happened,
如果这一切都曾经发生过。
And that the Chinese people were the descendants of the Tower of Babel.
而华人也是在巴比塔之后散出来的百姓。
They were the descendants of Noah.
他们是挪亚的后裔的话。
Surely they want to record all these global cataclysmic events.
当然他们要记载下这种全球灾难性的事件在。
And for the next 20 minutes or so, I'm going to show you that all these global events were documented in Chinese history.
接下来二十分钟，我让你看见所有全球世界都记载在华文历史里面。
Come on, let's give the Lord a big hand.
为之热烈的拍掌。
This is going to get really interesting because in this very next part, he's going to show how words actually symbolize different sentences. Since we now understand now, we know that the Chinese letters actually represent different images in the Chinese language. So whenever they write a letter, it's not just a letter like P or the letter M or the letter A or D. It actually represents something. It's an actual picture of something. So if they write a letter, it could represent, a mouse. It could be an image of a camera. It's really interesting and cool whenever they write down their letters. But when we look at the ancient Chinese letters, the traditional language, the traditional Chinese letters, we actually see that it symbolizes biblical things. And so it's very interesting because they still use it today. And so we'll go ahead and get into that part now.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All right.Go with me to Genesis 1 and verse 26. Let's start there.
创世纪章十六节这里开始。
It says, Genesis 1:26.
创世纪章十六节。
Then God said, "Let us make man in our image."
神说，让我们照我们的形象造人。
The word "make" also means to create.
这个造就是创造的造。
Create in Chinese is the word 造。
中文的造就是这个创造的造字。
Now notice how you write this word.
注意到这个字怎么写啊
？All right, this word is written this way.
这个字的写法是这样子。
There was speaking words.
首先有说话的告。
And as words were spoken, movement happens.
当这宣告说出，就有行动产生了。
So 走字旁 over words.
所以在这个告旁边是一个走字边。
And isn't it true when God spoke the word, living thing began to move?
不是这样吗？神一说话就开始活物出来了。
So right from the word create, you know that the creation story was recorded there.
从第一个创造的造字，你就看见创造的故事在里面。
And look at verse 22.
你看二十二节这里。
And God blessed them and saying, "Be fruitful and multiply."
神就赐福给他们，让他们生养众多。
Now we all Chinese, we love this word bless.
所有华人都很爱这个字福。
Chinese New Year, we see this everywhere.
农历年到处都看到这个字儿。
You know, and sometimes we have this word pasted on our doors and our businesses because this word means good fortune.
不管是家门口、公司门口都贴这个字，为什么？福气就是好运呢、啊、
？Yeah, and we want good fortune to come to our families and come to our workplace.
希望福气好运能够到我们的家里面，到公司里来。
And sometimes we write it, we turn it upside down.
有的时候故意倒着贴这个字儿。
That means the blessings to flow.
代表这个福到了。
But what is prosperity in its original meaning to the Chinese?
可是对华人来说，福原本的意思是什么？
How do you write 福？
福这个字怎么写的？
Now watch, it is 神字旁， it is God.
你看到旁边这个士字旁是神的意思。
Together at one with a mouth.
有一口代表一个人的单位。
So God together with a soul, one mouth.
代表神跟一个人，一个灵魂在一起。
In a garden.
在田园里
So that is prosperity.
这叫福分啊。
Prosperity to ancient Chinese is not just material wealth and money.
对古代华人来说，福分不光是金钱物质而已。
But it's for God and man to have a one relationship in a fruitful garden, in your fruitful family or in your workplace.
是神跟人有美好的关系，在美好的园子、你的公司、你的家庭、你的职场里面。
Oh, come on, you want to clap? Give the Lord a big clap.
我就热烈的拍掌。
Turn to your neighbor and say, God wants to have a good relationship with you.
跟旁边说。
So isn't that crazy that the word that they use in like Chinese tradition is kind of like, it's kind of taken away from the ancient Chinese traditional letters, which symbolize the Garden of Eden, of how God loved us, how we were blessed because of the Garden of Eden. Like, it's just like, it's crazy, like seeing that the ancient Chinese people actually worshiped the monotheistic Abrahamic God that we do. This is what your historians don't want you to know. They don't want you to know the truth, guys. I mean, if you guys understand the stuff that goes on behind history, like a lot of scientific, archaeological, and historical foundings are found to be true that prove Christianity is true, that the Word of God, the Bible is true. But then there's like a certain group, Smithsonian, Smithsonian. But there's like specific groups that like to... how can I say, suppress the truth. So they'll either do this through blackmail or they'll threaten them that we're not going to pay you anymore. You're going to get fired, things of that nature. And so this is what happens whenever people find the truth and want to reveal it. And this is why you see a lot of people don't like to reveal the truth, because it doesn't make money, guys. That's the truth of the matter. That's the reality. But at the end of the day, guys, I mean, the historical facts are there, and we actually do see that people from all around the world in ancient cultures actually did worship God Almighty, the monotheistic Abrahamic God. And it's really crazy because it proves the Tower of Babel occurred. It proves that God is so supreme and loving and all-knowing, and he even gave them grace in other countries who have never, quote-unquote, heard the gospel. He gave them the opportunity to come to him. So this shows that God can divinely reveal himself to all these cultures. So when people are like, oh, what about people in Peru and the Amazons that have never heard of the gospel of Jesus Christ? Are they going to go to hell? Well, no, actually, because scripture actually tells us in the book of Romans that he's going to judge them according to their heart, one. And two, we also see throughout history that God actually reveals himself to people divinely, which might be the case with the Chinese people. And he revealed himself to the people divinely without having an actual physical human being go to their civilization. So we see all throughout history, is my point, is that God can reveal himself in miraculous ways. He works in miraculous ways. So that argument that non-believers, specifically atheists, love to make against Christianity or any religion, it's just very insincere, it's disingenuous, and it's false. When we look at the Word of God stands true, and history confirms it. True history, true science, true archaeology supports the Word of God being true. Thank you guys so much for watching this. Let me know what you guys think about this, because I found this extremely interesting. I hope you guys do as well. Please share it with someone that you think this could be edifying for. And don't forget to like so the YouTube algorithm knows that you guys enjoy the video. And subscribe, turn on notifications if you haven't already, and comment what you guys think below. God bless you guys.